Hello, fellow warriors. Time to work on our combos today. So, let's open up the Beat 'em Up Template 2D and start kicking some ass. For this example, I've loaded up the training hall scene. You can find it in the scenes folder. So open it, and inside this level, you'll find a player prefab. Select it and go to the unit settings component in the inspector window. And here you find a tab called combo data. First variable is combo reset time. A combo always starts when an attack button is pressed. For example, I press the punch attack and then I press the punch attack again. Now the combo reset time variable is set to about half a second. Now if the second attack was pressed within half a second, then it will be considered as part of a combo. Otherwise the combo will just start from the beginning. The next variable is continue combo on hit. In other words, only continue with the combo if something was hit. Otherwise, just start from the beginning. Okay, now if you've opened this tab for the first time, there should be three combos here. Punch combo 1, punch combo 2, and a kick combo. Now, because I want to demonstrate how to set up new combos, I'm going to remove all of these and start from the beginning. Now, if I play the game and press the punch or kick button, you'll see that nothing happens because punch and kick actions are getting their information from the combo data. Okay, let's go back to the combo data tab. You'll see a button add combo. Press it and a new entry will appear. Open it and here we can put in the name of our combo. Let's call it punch kick combo. And next you'll see attack sequence. Press the plus button to add a new attack. Now let's fill in the data for this attack. The first one is attack name, so let's call it punch. And the next one is the damage that will be inflicted on the target when it's hit. Let's set this to 1. And then we have a field called sound effect on hit. I'm going to put in hit sound effect. Every scene has an audio controller. This is where all these sound effects are listed. Okay, next is animation state. Now every unit has an animator component. I'll show you where it is. If you move up, then you have animator, and this one has an animator controller called player. So I'm going to open it and here you can see all these states that the player controller has. Now the names of these states, that's important because that is the name that we have to fill in the animation state field of the combo. So let's go back and fill in punch 1. And again, I have to stress this is not the animation name, but the name of the state as defined in the animator controller. Okay, the last one is an attack type and in this case it is a punch. And then we have the last setting, the knockdown. So if this attack causes a knockdown on hit. Okay, that's it for the first attack. So let's go to the next one. Press the plus button again to add a new attack. And this time it will be a kick. I'm going a little bit faster through these settings since I've already explained them. First of all, the name, let's do kick. And the damage will be 2. Sound effect on hit, again, hit sound effect. Animation state, let's do kick 2. The attack type is kick, and let's do a knockdown for this one. So knockdown 2. Okay, so now we have a combo that consists of 2 attacks, a punch and a kick. So let's test this. I'm going to press play to enter the training hall. And this scene was actually added to test this kind of stuff. Since you don't have any enemies to worry about, you can just play around with your settings. Okay, so here you can see it in action. So this is how you set up a 2-attack combo, and of course you can make combos as long as you want. And this, my friends, is how game developers exercise.